If you have heard about the Scam Manifesto or even read it, you probably have a strong opinion about this book, one way or another. People usually do. For you who haven't heard about it yet, this is a political manifesto that divides humanity into two equally sized halves, where one half is designated as evil and the other as good. The book, The Scam Manifesto, argues that the good half of humanity should murder everybody in the bad half and also murder everybody in the good half who is not in favor of this genocide. Can such an argument ever be a good thing? Well, of course it can, if it's the right kind of sarcasm. If it points out some really bad discrimination or bigotry and exaggerates it to show how deplorable it is. For example, we have Jonathan Swift's A Modest Proposal, where he argued against the English oppression of Ireland by sarcastically arguing that the English ought to start slaughtering babies and eat them. The Irish really liked this argument for having their babies killed because it was obvious sarcasm and the sarcasm was in their favor. However, that's not how the Scam Manifesto works. On the contrary, Scam Manifesto is pure bigotry. It really hates half of humanity and actually wants them dead. That is not a good thing. Yet, there are people who defend Scam Manifesto. A lot of people think that it's not so bad because. Yeah, because of what? Make a guess if you haven't read about this book already. Well, the good half of humanity in this book is women, and the bad half is men. Is bigotry okay if it's done by women against men? Well, there are a few ways that one could argue such a statement. First of all, one could claim that men are in fact bad and women are in fact good. This argument is pure bigotry. Nothing more, nothing less. It is obviously not true. Humans are individuals, period. One could say that some are good and some are bad. I wouldn't go so far as to divide people that much, but sufficient to say, good and bad are in people of both genders. However, there's not only the matter of individuals, but also the matter of social structures, oppressive social structures, where people get oppressed for their gender or their race or whatever. Structures that have been building for centuries and even millennia. And there is a lot of oppression against women in this world. Some would argue against that. I'm not going to make an argument today. Sufficient to say, I think that women as a group are much more oppressed than men as a group. And regardless of whether or not this is true, a lot of people believe this. And this is very relevant for the discussion about the Scam Manifesto. Is it okay for an oppressed group to be bigoted? Is it even a good thing? Well, as I argued in the previous clip, it's not a good thing, but it can be okay sometimes. If you really need your bigotry to step out of that hole and realize that you are a human being with real human value, yes, you can afford to be a bit bigoted for a little while, but this is not something we should encourage. This is something we need to get past as soon as possible. celebrating the Scum Manifesto is the entirely wrong way to go. Bigotry is bigotry, and this is a very destructive force to be toying with. This destructiveness is not limited to the imminent danger of hate crimes. Yes, there is more problem when a violent group spreads bigotry or when a privileged group does so, but regardless of who is spreading bigotry, it is still, at the very least, about answering the wrong questions. It's about who should we hate instead of how do we end the hatred. It is how should we divide and trample people rather than how can we stop this dividing and trampling. We don't need more hatred in the world. We don't need that people divide each other in good and bad halves of humanity at all. It's not the kind of world we should be striving for. Different people favor different groups, different categories of people. And the basic rules are much stronger when they are equal for all. If you argue that bigotry is okay as long as it's done by a group that you favor, then how are you going to convince anyone that the groups they favor will not be allowed to be bigots?